Hello everyone, welcome to another Power Talk with Archana. Today we are talking about my favorite topic, happiness. Everything that's sparkling, everything that's colorful, everything that brings happiness into your life. As we open the Happiness Week today with Shubha Sandeep from Internal Insights, I would like to take you to a journey where everything talks about happiness and making your life easier with colors flashing all across your life. Now, Shubha is a very dear friend. She's a life coach and a spiritual leader, and she started her journey at the age of 13. She learned the art of creating balance in the spiritual and practical world very early in life. She has also penned down her thoughts in her audiobook explaining the Ashtavakra Gita, and she is on her way to pen down another very important, dear to our hearts, Bhagavad Gita, very easy to understand by our younger generation. Let's welcome our very dear friend Shubha Sandeep as we both discuss about what is happiness, how to add colors to your life, and custom make your recipe for happiness. Let's welcome a very dear friend, Shubha Sandeep. Hello, Shubha. How are you doing today?
Great. Nice talking to you, Archana. How are you doing today?
I'm very well, feeling happy and all set to spread happiness across. So let's start this journey. Tell me one thing, Shubha. Let's discuss something very important, very dear to my heart. Let's try and make people happy today. Let's give them a recipe of happiness. So what do you think is your recipe for staying happy?
It's actually very simple, Archana. To be able to be happy is something which is very personal to you. It depends on your thought processes. It depends exactly how you want to feel about yourself, how you want to lead your life. So when you ask me the question about a recipe, it's there is no typical hard and fast recipe like you cook a food and you say this is the recipe. Basically, if you ask me, I would like to give you the path. And the path being, you need to understand where can this thing called happiness be sourced from. So if you know that it is available here, you can go and pick it up, right? Now, what is the biggest myth we are all living in? We are living in one of the biggest myths, which is happiness is an external thing. It can be sought after. We have to run behind it. It is depending on so many things. Oh, if I buy a new car, I'll be happy. Oh, if I have a lovely house, I'll be happy. Oh, if I have this dream partner who would love me like crazy, why do I need that? You know why? Because that's going to make me happy. And you know what? If I make this big 5-figure salary, ooh, I'll be really happy. Now, that's great. All of this, if you ask me, is a byproduct anyways. Now, that's really something, right? That this is a byproduct anyways. A human being, when they are born on this planet, they are born with an entire package, you know. The Almighty wants us to be nothing less than happy. That is our purpose, to experience happiness every second, irrespective of you getting this or getting that. The moment you are dependent on something external, very risky scenario to be in. Honestly, if you ask me, that is not happy. You know why? Because I'm constantly coming from the space of dependence, and dependence is not our true nature. Where does happiness spring from, darling? Happiness springs from coming into your source. Happiness comes from operating from your own self, standing on your own self. Now, you can ask me, Archana, but Shubha, aren't we standing on our own selves? We have our 2 feet, na? So, we're standing on our own selves. No, that's not where I'm coming from. That's a very physical aspect of life. That's fine. Yeah. I'm talking about something which is going to give you a permanency. Operating from the space of your mind, a mind that understands contentment, that understands fulfillment, that understands being steady and strong, and depending on your own mental state. Now, to experience happiness unconditionally should be the mantra, is the norm. Wow. Unconditionalness is the source of happiness.
Shubha, I really love it. I mean, it's all about your love from the inside. It's about self-love. It's about, you know, staying happy from within. It's about not depending on people on the outside, you know, to give you happiness. So you need to feel secure. You need to feel happy. You need to feel fulfilled from the inside to feel happy and stay happy and create happiness for people around you. I think this is really wonderful. What else would you like to add, Shubha?
So we've always been talking about doing for achieving. Very rarely have any of us heard about just being. Being and achieving happens anyways. So it's a lot about being. And again, operating from your source. And how will all of that happen? It will happen through wisdom, internal awakening. Internal awakening without which there is nothing internally great about you. If you have no treasure inside, you will automatically fall back on the outside world. Now, the outside world is brilliant. No doubt about it. It is the divine gift. It is brilliant. However, it is only a reflection of your internal magnificent being. It is just a reflection of that. So what goes on here gets manifested there. What goes on here gets felt here. So if you want to experience this beautiful emotion, this beautiful feeling of constant, unconditional happiness, what do we have to do? What is the recipe? You have to create a healthy thought. You have to create that healthy thought from an extremely healthy mind. Learn the art of internally vibrating at a very high frequency. So when can you vibrate at a very high frequency? If apne aap me, sitting with myself, and I'm feeling so happy with myself. Why? Because the mind, it's a very simple formula I'm going to give you. The focus of the mind being external, withdraw the energy from that.
This is really amazing. All we are talking about today is unleashing your internal energies to give happiness to yourself and the people around you. I think this is something really amazing. So as we work on unleashing our internal energies to bring happiness and lots of happiness as we wake up to a beautiful morning each day, we will catch you tomorrow once again as me and Shubha discuss another aspect of how you can create happiness in your relationships. Until then, stay tuned and we will catch you tomorrow with another aspect of happiness. Take care and stay tuned for more.